Following the sack, third and long for Bortles and the Jags. Began his career as a Saint. This is Chris Ivory. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. A good pickup there, 7 yards, but it brings up fourth down.
I like what they were thinking on defense. Just guard the first down sticks. Don't let anyone pass that. Didn't matter whether they threw it or ran it. They just ended up rallying to the football on the running play and stopped them short of a first down.
And the first play will be a field goal try. From the left hash, this will be a 52-yard attempt. And this one is right down Broadway. And they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And now out come the Jets. And a 3-and-out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out with a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive?
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
He's going to fire one deep over the middle. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. Dancing to his left. It's a loss of two, now third down. And defensively, a dime look here. Six DBs on third and 12.
No surprise at all.
Let's go. Green, 39 now. Look at 56.
He'll look to throw. Wide open receiver complete. And they finally get him down, but not before he reaches the 34. It's a big play there for the Jets on third. 43 yards. And again, this time to the tailback. And he's going to be run over, hit hard, as he'll be marked down. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
They'll look to throw here. That's caught right side by Anderson. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
They'll look to throw for it on third and 1. The swing pass caught. And they do stop him, but he takes it all the way to the 2. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They're going to look to throw. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by Jalen Ramsey. And the return won't go anywhere. They'll be back deep in their own territory at the 2-yard line.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
And not great starting field position here for the offense.
Z, 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 Z.
give. This is their fullback. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 5-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Normally when you see a short gain in the middle of a 3-4 defense, go ahead and pat the nose tackle on the back, because he's holding things up and taking on extra blockers, which allows one of the inside linebackers to roam free and make the tackle.
Bortles on the give to Fournette. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he's going to get this one all the way up to the 30. A big hitter there. A first down gain of 26 yards.
Okay, every now and then, my defensive bias will leak out here. Abysmal play for them. You've got them backed up, and you let them out.
Couldn't take advantage. And you know who's happy? The punter. Because if he was needed, they gave him a lot of space to work with now.
Yeah, because he would have had a lot to think about, right? Don't step over the back line and give him a safety. Now he's got room if he needed it.
They keep it with Fournette on first down. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
That's another nice run, and I have to tell you, some of the coaches that I played for, their philosophies were always different when they see a guy running the ball well. Some of them wanted to immediately go to play action and throw it now because it's wide open. Well, other coaches said, you know something? Until they stop him, that big boy's going to keep getting the football. And that might be the direction that they're going to go right now.
Down is Bortles. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Throwing on second down. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Cole. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A 14-yard first down pickup for the Jaguars.
But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. They'll toss it to Fournette. Inside the 20 before he's brought down. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
They'll run it again with Fournette, and now running right through it. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down, but a nice little gain. They'll get 6 on the play, and it's going to take us to the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back with more of the AFC Championship game after this. Now they'll throw it. Bortles steps away to his left. This will be caught at about the 6. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. Bortles on the hook up to Hearns for the Jaguar first down.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
They'll try to run with Rawls. And he'll take this one in for a Jags touchdown. Thomas Rawls, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Jags are able to cash in for 6.
I wonder if he changed anything on his play sheet or they just executed better. Because they had 2 previous drives that ended in field goals before this one they finally were able to put into the end zone.
Well, whatever he did, speaking of the offensive coordinator, might be using that formula going forward. It worked there.
Yeah, it worked very well. He and his field general in pretty good sync right now. They're starting to move the ball well.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Now the Jets offense gets ready to head back on the field. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first 2 drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now. And I'm going to take it into the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. Caught, Seferian Jenkins, right side. A Jet 1st down, 18 big yards that time.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Now on 1st down, he'll drop to throw it. Incomplete, over the middle, Seferian Jenkins. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. Chewing up big yardage, another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. They'll drop to throw. Now he'll let it go deep. And this is caught inside the 5. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Robbie Anderson, 37 yards. And the Jets can take the lead now with the extra point. And that one will give them the lead here as we approach halftime. Now the punter, who also does the kickoff duties, Locke Edwards, out to kick it away. This one taken from the 7. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time, do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
They start on the ground with Rawls, and he powers his way up past the 30. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on 1st down. Clock running as Bortles hurries to try to get his guys set. Shotgun now for Bortles. And he is going to be hit and taken down. Bortles sacked. Now here's a timeout defensively. Defensive timeout called by the Jets. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Throwing his Bortles on 3rd down. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Now the Jets are going to burn another timeout. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime.
And the Jaguars send out their punter. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And it's taken in at the 9. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And how about this? He takes it all the way back. No time, no flags. A punt return touchdown and a stunning end of the first half.
And they kicked it to him. They kicked it to him.
Vinatieri now to tack on the PAT. And with that, the lead is up to 8. So we come upon halftime in the AFC title game. As we'll send you down the coast to Orlando, where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Jet offense now. They head out to take over. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Green, 30.
Over, over, over.
Watching that, Barney.
Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
A lot of contact there, but there was no way it appeared that he was going to get a flag on that one. Looking for it, but he wasn't going to get it. And as an ex-defensive back, you love it when they let you play and jostle downfield.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Flushed out right. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he finally goes down, but not before reaching the 21. Big yardage that time for the Jets. And even 40 yards.
All right, here we go. Three, nine.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
It's real easy to say this running game needs to be better, but the reality is they've been given little time to actually find a place to run the football. It's almost like the defense is there on the handoff.
Now a handoff looking right. He's to the 10. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. A great effort there. A 22-yard scamper. And the Jets find a way to stretch their lead. And the lead is up to 15 now. Now the punter, who also does the kickoff duties, Locke Edwards, out to kick it away. This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know, in the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
Over the middle, the connection to Hearns. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. That goes for a gain of 31.
A lot of receivers see the drag route as a risk-reward type of a play. The risk, going into the middle of the field where there's some big people who want to hit you. But the reward is oftentimes you get lost in coverage, running a little bit underneath. And when you catch it just right, as we just saw there, the end result can be a big, big play.
And he's going to take this one down to the 25. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Open space inside the 10. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. Thomas Rawls, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Jaguars make some inroads here on that deficit. And he's able to put it through. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. So out now come the Jets. They were able to extend their lead with an opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter, but that just got matched a moment ago.
So we know that what they discussed at the half worked. Now, what are the counters to that, right? You don't just run the same things over and over. Some do, but many will also show something and then come back with something else to keep the defense off balance.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off around the 41. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20.
Well, so much of playing quarterback in the snow comes down to trying not to do too much. You've got to just keep telling yourself, throws downfield we've run every day in practice all year. But guess what? They suddenly become more difficult. And this one gets away from him and winds up an interception.
A handoff, Fournette running left. And he's eaten up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard down to the 16.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Now Leonard Fournette. He will push his way down to about the 14. Only a gain of a couple there. That leaves him needing about 7 here on third down. Not the start to the drive they were looking for. That run doesn't do much at all.
No, not at all. And it leaves them with third and long. And you know, this is the time of game where these drives really, really start to matter. They've got to make some moves.
From the gun on third down, Bortles. Buying time to his left. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on. A big call coming on third down. So he was past the line of scrimmage when he threw it.
And as they say, that's a no-no. Got to be able to understand where you are on the field and not cross the line before throwing the ball downfield.
And his kick is good. And the drive will wind up yielding 3. So make it 3 field goals for him now. And this last one tightens things up a bit.
And I know that offense is on the sideline right about now, checking out the tablets and saying, man, we let a good chance slip away there. We've got to start finishing some of these drives.
And New York set to take the field. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Big boys down there in the trenches and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you're talking about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
All right, here we go.
Back to throw now on 2nd and 10. Looking left side, he's got it, complete. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. The reception good for 7. It's 3rd down. The Jets on 3rd down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3. Looking to throw. And he finds Safarian Jenkins. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. They convert on third with a gain of 22. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Now they try the right side here. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And he is going to feel that one. Knocked down hard. The Jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. They go play action here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
Now let's go. Green, 39. Now looking for the second. Green, 19.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down. Well, this is how you shape the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4-for-4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when who told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row. I'm going to stay confident, keep flinging it. I just figured there's something wrong with the football.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll have the first down, getting this one to the 14-yard line. Give him 12 yards there, and the Jets have a first.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense gets a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. And this play goes nowhere, losing yardage back to the 15. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a second and 11. Now, this will be the 9th play on this drive. Looking right. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. The Jets on third down. They've been near perfect. 4-for-5 to this point. This is 3rd and 7. He'll look to throw. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you. You change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest ones, maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the Jaguars' offense as they get set here. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I've never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it. So while the offense has had a big day, no one on that side of the ball is excited about seeing a loss like that. Their goal, to make every play positive. And when you have a bad one like that, you're...
He rifles one that's intercepted. Marcus May with a pick. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football?
because you can make an educated guess defensively. Not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Robbie Anderson, the man he was looking for, and it's third down. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. In motion, Seferian Jenkins. He'll drop to throw. And this is caught at the 8. And he's brought down, but not before reaching the 8-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Back to throw. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off down near the 5. He's at the 50. 30. 20. 10. And they will score. It's a Jacksonville touchdown.
Now that was a beautiful play. A pick 6. How would you punctuate something like that, partner?
What, you mean with an exclamation mark?
Exclamation mark, a big word. What would you do with that?
Ampersand?
I like it.
And now out come the Jags. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window? Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7. And the failure to convert and tie the game. Now the pressure shifts back to the defense.
But I think it was the right play. I think it was the right call to try and tie the game there. Kick an extra point, you're still down 1. What's the sense? I like what they did.
This will be fielded at the 8. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. The Jets offensive unit ready to get going here. And following the pick 6, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick 6. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing in a situation where they actually need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it.
Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 46. Malik Jackson getting in there from his defensive tackle spot to snow him under for a loss of 4. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now back to throw. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Malik Jackson in there to pick up his 2nd sack now of the afternoon. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after 1st and 2nd down went backwards. It's 3rd and very long. They'll set up to throw. And he finds a man on the crossing route. A very solid gain of 27. Big hook up there, forced to throw it on 3rd down. The connection's going to keep the drive alive and also keep the clock moving.
Yeah, and from a defensive perspective, didn't get a sack, didn't knock the ball free, didn't break up the pass. The clock keeps running on you. You're in a dire situation now.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down. Offensively, with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
The Jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
And he'll get this down only to the 18. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. And this defense right now, backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in. And all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, this game's over.
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Very tough spot here for the offense to start. They'll start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette. And he'll get him a little space here up to the 5-yard line. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
And give him a lot of credit there, but even more credit to the guys up front. In that situation, you know it's going to be a stacked defensive front. And to be able to gain that much yardage, that's a big win for the guys on offense.
Yeah, they're just about standing on their own goal line, so to get a few yards there, a great start. Now we'll see what second down brings. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
I don't know about you, partner, but I'm rubbing my eyes after that play. Did we just see that runner not get yardage? A big-time play by the defense.
It does happen occasionally, even against the best running backs who are having big days.
From the gun, it's Bortles. Looking long for Westbrook. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
There's definitely contact there, but it's the fourth quarter of a kind of tight game, and sometimes the officials just say, let them play. Kind of like your mom used to, you and your brothers, just take the broom to you and send you out to the backyard and tell you to settle it yourselves.
I like that, yeah. There was contact, I don't know, like you said, enough to warrant the flag. It was close, though. And the Jaguars send out their punter. Remember, his first attempt was returned for a touchdown. And he's able to get it out quickly, and this is not a bad kick here. Taken right around the 44. And it's a touchdown for the Jets. So they boost their advantage here in the fourth quarter. And don't get me wrong, you take the points. I guess the only downside is didn't really get to milk any of the clock here in this last quarter.
But they'll take the points because, as you and I both know, here in the fourth quarter, things intensify. And while they may not have taken firm command of the game, it does give them a little bit of a cushion.
So after surrendering the punt return for a score, let's see what they can do in turn on this kickoff. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Here comes the Jaguars offense as they get set to go again. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. The offense certainly looking to score some points, but they also need ball security here late as we get down to the final moments of this one. Throwing now is Bortles. Completes it to Hearns. Time for a break. Back to wrap up the AFC Championship game after this. On first and 10, here's Bortles. That's to the right side, complete to Kittle. 10 yards there, good enough for a Jags first down. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. Clock running as Bortles hurries to try to get his guys set. Again, it's Fournette. And some room to maneuver. 16 yards that time on the pickup for the Jags and a first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. They'll run it now out of the gun. It's a 6 yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four. Clock running here, under 90 seconds to go.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. Clock running as Bortles hurries to try to get his guys set. Back to throw. Being chased out left. Oh, no, he lost the football. And it's scooped up by the Jets. The Red Sea parts, and there he goes. Past the 20. And this defense has broken it open as they return it to the house for six. So a great play there by the defense. If these guys are going to advance, and it looks like they will, this defense a big reason why.
And they love carrying the mantle for this team, don't they? You see the way that they move around out there? They want to lead this team deeper into the playoffs and hopefully onto the Super Bowl.
And that return for a touchdown certainly helps that cause. Bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Jaguars getting set to go. And they weren't on the sidelines for long, but I'll tell you what, I'm glad you and I weren't down there. We could hear them, the coaches from all the way up here. They were adamant, you've got to hold on to the football or else we have no hope.
Yeah, it's easy for me to laugh sitting up here, but you're exactly right. If we were down there, that message would have been received a whole different way. Because turnovers, they've been a big problem for them. Got to take care of the football. Got to hold on to it.
They begin with a run by Fournette, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Defense showing blitz. To throw on second down. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Marcus May with a pick, and his guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
Obviously disappointing, but you had to go for broke here, down two scores. So that forced you to make some throws you definitely wouldn't want to make. And I think this interception is going to pretty much write an end to this one.
Defense still with three timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them here as the kneel down comes. And with this win and an AFC championship, they have reached the most hallowed ground in all of sports.
That means they are the best in their conference. What an incredible feeling for this team to go through the entire season and come out on top and now go to the Super Bowl.
know everybody got problems, yeah, but we didn't know one way to solve them. I really came up from the bottom, struggling my mama on the last dollar. Hustling, man, I've been putting in these hours. The government been trying to take it where it's ours. Really all about the money and the power. I just want to see my people in power. Tell me how we gonna shape this vision. Complaining all day, but in the same condition. If you want to make change, it's gonna take commitment. Some people enslaved by their religion. Can't emancipate the fundamental principles. What I see through optics, transform the wisdom. Watch me use my prophets, get them on the list. And I've been on a mission. And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless, and I really can't help it. I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, can you help me? Everybody got fights, yeah, but wouldn't know what good advice was. Till I leave him lifeless. Another mama crying, it's another crisis. Lord knows we're just trying to live righteous. Are you willing just to make the sacrifices? I know we can't continue living like this. And I never sell my soul, cause that's priceless. Tell me how we gonna make a living. Hustle on the block, who gonna save the children? Man, it's all a plot, and I'm just revealing. The media just trying to make a villain. I just take the pain to paint a picture of. Voices in my head, I hear the whispers when I feel this way. And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless, and I really can't help it. I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, can you help me? It's just the way I feel. So long, it's just the way to deal with these problems alone. And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm living on restless. I said, Lord, can you help me? I've never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, can you help me?
Today to talk about how I feel, and I feel like that we are treated differently than other people, and I don't like how we're treated, and just because of us doesn't mean anything to me.
It's just the way I feel. Mine's been racing so long. Selfish people, I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, can you help me? Now everybody got problems, yeah, but we didn't know one way to solve them. I really came up from the bottom, struggling my mama on the last dollar. Hustling, man, I've been putting in these hours. The government been trying to take it where it's ours. Really all about the money and the power. I just want to see my people in power. Tell me how we gonna shape this vision. Complaining all day, but in the same condition. If you want to make change, it's gonna take commitment. Some people enslaved by their religion. Can't emancipate the fundamental principles. What I see through optics, transform the wisdom. Watch me use my prophets, get them on the list. And I've been on a mission. And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless, and I really can't help it. I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, can you help me? Now everybody got fights,
Yeah, but wouldn't know what good advice was. Till they leave him lifeless. Another mama crying, it's another crisis. Lord knows we're just trying to live righteous. Are you willing just to make the sacrifices? I know we can't continue living like this. And I never sell my soul, cause that's priceless. Tell me how we gonna make a living. Hustle on the block, who gonna save the children? Man, it's all a plot, and I'm just revealing. The media just trying to make a villain. I just take the pain and paint a picture. Voices in my head, I hear the whispers when I feel its weight. And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless. And I really can't help it. I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, can you help me? Can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm living on restless.
I said, Lord, can you help me?
I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me?
I said, Lord, can you help me?
Today to talk about how I feel, and I feel like that we are treated differently than other people, and I don't like how we're treated, and just because of us doesn't mean anything to me.
It's just the way I feel. Mine's been racing so long. Now everybody got problems, yeah, but we didn't know one way to solve them. I really came up from the bottom, struggling, my mama on the last dollar. Hustling, man, I've been putting in these hours. The government been trying to take it where it's ours. Really all about the money and the power. I just want to see my people in power. Tell me how we gonna shape this vision. Complaining all day, but in the same condition. If you want to make change, it's gonna take commitment. Some people enslaved by their religion. Can't emancipate the fundamental prisons. What I see through optics, transform the wisdom. Watch me use my prophets, get them on the listen. I've been on a mission. And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless.
And I really can't help it.
I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me?
I said, Lord, can you help me?
Everybody got vices, yeah, but wouldn't know what good advice was. Till they leave him lifeless. Another mama crying, it's another crisis. Lord knows we're just trying to live righteous. Are you willing just to make the sacrifices? I know we can't continue living like this. And I never sell my soul, cause that's priceless. Tell me how we gonna make a living. Hustle on the block, who gonna save the children? Man, it's all a plot, and I'm just revealing. The media just trying to make a villain. I just take the pain and paint a picture. Voices in my head, I hear the whispers when I feel its weight. And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless.
And I really can't help it.
I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me?
I said, Lord, can you help me?
It's just the way I feel. My
really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptation, my Lord. I'm running on restless.
I said, Logie,
I've never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. To me, Logie, you help me.
I said, Logie, help me.
Today to talk about how I feel, and I feel like that we are treated differently than other people, and I don't like how we're treated, and just because of us doesn't mean anything to me.
It's just the way I feel. Mine's been racing so long.
Everybody got problems, yeah, but we didn't know one way to solve them. I really came up from the bottom, struggling my mama on the last dollar. Hustling, man, I've been putting in these hours. The government been trying to take it where it's ours. Really all about the money and the power. I just want to see my people in power. Tell me how we gonna shape this vision. Complaining all day, but in the same condition. If you want to make change, it's gonna take commitment. Some people enslaved by their religion. Can't emancipate the fundamental principles. What I see through optics, transform the wisdom. Watch me use my prophets, get them on the listen. I've been on a mission.
And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless,
and I really can't help it.
I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me?
I said, Lord, can you help me?
Everybody got fights, yeah, but wouldn't know what good advice was. Till they leave him lifeless. Another mama crying, it's another crisis. Lord knows we're just trying to live righteous. Are you willing just to make the sacrifices? I know we can't continue living like this. And I never sell my soul, cause that's priceless. Tell me how we gonna make a living. Hustle on the block, who gonna save the children? Man, it's all a plot, and I'm just revealing. The media just trying to make a villain. I just take the pain and paint a picture of. Voices in my head, I hear the whispers when I feel its weight.
And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless.
And I really can't help it.
I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me?
I said, Lord, can you help me?
So long, it's just the way it feels with these problems alone. And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptation, my Lord. I'm living on restless.
I said, Logie, help me.
I've never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. To me, Logie, you help me.
I said, Logie, help me.
Thank you.
chasing so long. Yeah, it's just no way to deal with these problems alone.
And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless. And I really can't help it. I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord.
Now everybody got problems, yeah, but we didn't know one way to solve them. I really came up from the bottom, struggling my mama on the last dollar. Hustling and I've been putting in these hours. The government been trying to take it where it's ours. Really all about the money and the power. I just want to see my people in power. Tell me how we gonna shape this vision. Complaining all day but in the same condition. If you want to make change, it's gonna take commitment. Some people enslaved by their religion. Can't emancipate the fundamental prisons. What I see through optics transform the wisdom. Watch me use my prophets, get them on the listen. I've been on a mission.
And I really can't take it no more. My temptations, my Lord, I'm young and I'm restless. And I really can't help it. I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, can you help me?
Everybody got fights, yeah, but wouldn't know what good advice was. Till I leave him lifeless. Another mama crying, it's another crisis. Lord knows we're just trying to live righteous. Are you willing just to make the sacrifices? I know we can't continue living like this. And I never sell my soul, cause that's priceless. Tell me how we gonna make a living. Hustle on the block, who gonna save the children? Man, it's all a plot, and I'm just revealing. The media just trying to make a villain. I just take the pain to paint a picture of. Voices in my head, I hear the whispers when I feel this way.
And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless. And I really can't help it. I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, can you help me?
It's just the way. So long, yeah. It's just the way to deal with these problems alone. Not really can't take it no more. I've been finding temptation, my Lord. I'm living on restless.
I said, Lord, can you help me?
I've never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. To me, Lord, can you help me?
I said, Lord, can you help me?
Today to talk about how I feel, and I feel like that we are treated differently than other people, and I don't like how we're treated, and just because of us doesn't mean anything to me.
It's just the way I feel. Mine's been racing so long. Yeah, it's just no way.
Selfish people, I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, can you help me?
Now everybody got problems, yeah, but we didn't know one way to solve them. I really came up from the bottom, struggling my mama on the last dollar. Hustling and I've been putting in these hours. The government been trying to take it where it's ours. Really all about the money and the power. I just want to see my people in power. Tell me how we gonna shape this vision. Complaining all day but in the same condition. If you want to make change, it's gonna take commitment. Some people enslaved by their religion. Can't imagine.